Well, my mother loved food too. She did. She loved her kids.
Loved to write.
She loved to write. She understood and really conveyed to us that work was a great passion, that you couldn't live without work. That's when you were asked what are you going to be when you grow up? The question was answered in terms of work, not in terms of motherhood or being married. It was what are you going to do?
And is that the way you define it?
The great passion?
Yeah.
Probably.
And journalism. Tell me about the arc of your attitude about journalism.
Oh, I think...
Why are you looking
well,
at me?
No,
because you know
no.
I know what you're going to say.
No, because journalism was something that I was as deeply in love with as anything I've ever been in love with. It was so romantic. It was so... I had grown up not seeing the great movies because they weren't re-showing them on television when I was a kid yet. But the aura of the front page and... Even in Superman on television, Lois Lane and the Daily Planet, it looked like a great job, and it is the greatest job.
And it was. You liked the stories you covered. You liked the idea of doing it.
You
liked the process
it.
Of doing it. You liked the people who did it.
I think it is a fantastic job. Now I kind of look back on it the way you look back on someone you were once in love with that you bump into and you think, what did I ever see in him?
Yes, I know.
But, as you get a little wiser. And about the pretensions of journalism when I was young and still, the pretensions to truth. I really did think that when you wrote a story, you were writing the truth. It was a complete...
Well, you suggest in here that when you used to believe that when people said they were misquoted, it simply was not true. They were lying.
Yes.
Now you believe it's possible that they're telling the truth,
of
that they
course.
Were in fact misquoted, and
of
maybe
course.
They had been, and probably they were.
Well, for sure we've all been misquoted.
Yes.
For sure we have all been misquoted, and that one word is left out that makes it funny or doesn't make it funny.
Since you have been the object of many, many stories... What is it about that's written about you that drives you crazy?
Oh,
let your candor kick in.
I think you always feel that every so often somebody gets you in some way or other. But that, one of the things I know is that people are so complicated, I don't know how... anyone can ever attempt to get anyone, much less those of us who.
So when someone tell me when
story,
someone got
Charlie.
You and tell me when someone got you and what they got.
Oh, well, I can't think of it because I don't think.
Well,
about
who was
that
it?
Stuff.
And I'll go look it up.
I don't know.
So is there a misconception about you that's there?
Oh, I don't think about that stuff.
You don't.
I'm just typing.
Is it getting easier?
No, it's not getting easier.
Because it's comedy or what?
No, I think that as you get older, you don't want to repeat yourself. I mean, that's one of the things that I felt, even after 5 years at the New York Post when I was, 26 or 27 years old, I thought, oh, I've covered this before. I know the lead to this story. How do I do it in a way that's different? I think that keeping yourself fresh is a difficult thing in the aging process, and finding things that are hard for you is something that you have to do, or else you just repeat yourself.
Or else you don't grow.
Yeah.
Join us online at charlierose.com.